Simulated here. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you are new here. Today we are going ahead and playing Let's Play The Sims 4 Get Famous for Part 18. So as you can see right now, Lakeisha is going ahead and sitting down on her couch, eating some breakfast and watching TV, and her babies are already crying again. She got up about 5 times last night. She only had about like 1 hour sleep at any given time, and she's already having to go ahead and take care of her baby. So we'll go ahead and do that in a minute. I will just let her eat because like she is in the worst mood ever. We went to bed when she passed out last night, and we've been on and off sleeping until like 9 a.m. and she still hasn't got her sleep all the way up. But anyway, we got this offer. It says, "Hello Lakeisha, the Fishing Sport Association is looking for a celebrity partner to help promote their No Fish Left Behind campaign that introduces youth to the wholesome sport of fishing. Complete one of the next following options in the next 24 hours to fulfill this contract. Use video station to upload any video footage, or use a drone and go fishing and then upload the fishing video." So we're probably going to go ahead and do that. Wow, this makeup routine video got like $300. Holy guacamole. So we're going to go ahead and take care of our babies. Go ahead and maybe film that video. It's like thundering outside, so I'm not sure. But audition is at 7 p.m. So we're going to go ahead, go to that. We've already got comedy level like 4 and almost 5. So we should definitely get this gig. And we'll go ahead and do this gig in this part as well. But we are going to be going ahead and aging up the babies in this part too, which is going to be really exciting because I'm sick of waking up to them every 5 minutes. Okay, you guys. So we've gone ahead and headed on down to the park. And we've invited some of our friends over here to come ahead and go fishing with us. These are our friends from the acting career. So we are going ahead and going fishing while we film it. We borrowed Michaela's drone, and we're just going to go ahead and film this for a little bit, I guess, maybe until the drone like runs out of battery or whatever. We're just going to go ahead and go fishing. Oh no, our 15 minutes of fame are up. And we need to go ahead and definitely... Is she getting excited about us? Cute. We definitely need to go ahead and go to the awards ceremony on Sunday. And we're going to go ahead and hopefully get gold in this TV gig. That'll probably be on Friday. And we'll just keep on working on our acting skill. But right now over here, we are currently almost at a 3rd star celebrity. So I'm going to go ahead and get her to stop fishing and then stop the recording. It'll be called fishing hashtag ad. And I'm just going to go ahead and put this in my inventory because we definitely don't want to lose this since it is Michaela's. And we're going to go ahead and sign some autographs for our fans just to make them happy. Go ahead and sign this little girl's autograph as well, because I think that's a really nice thing to do, you know, while she's out here fishing, just to go ahead and sign this little girl's autograph. She looks so happy. Who is she? We don't know her really. I don't know who she is. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and sign some autographs. So what we're going to go ahead and do now is, let me just check her other aspiration. So the other one is in popularity, right? So yeah, we just need to become a 3rd star celebrity. So I might just keep on, I'm just gonna have her go ahead and practice singing and stuff to earn some fame, see if we can get up to 3 star. Go ahead and begin a stream and then practice some singing. Oh, where are we going? Oh, I need to go to work. I need to go to my audition. Oh my goodness, I think we just lost Michaela's drone at the park. Oh no. Okay, so once Michaela found out that her friend Lakeisha had gone ahead and left her drone at the park, because she was live streaming when it happened, she went ahead and headed on over to the park together with her friend Annika so they could go ahead and try and find it. They had seen like where she was vlogging before, and they could see on the stream like where it ended, but they didn't get to go ahead and see exactly where it landed. So they're just going to go ahead and look. She's going to tell her friend Annika this dramatic story and go ahead and gossip to her. And the funny thing is, we've actually gone ahead and left Chloe and Noah home alone right now. They are home alone. There is no one there to take care of them. And so we're going to go ahead and tell her, yeah, my friend, she has these twins that she had from this one night stand. She's so irresponsible. She's left me to take care of her babies, and she left my drone here. So I don't care. I've just gone ahead and left her kids alone. And then we come on over here and we're going to go ahead and find our drone. Thankfully, it didn't get rained on. So we're going to go ahead and put that in our inventory. Thank goodness we found it. We'll go ahead and give her a bit of a hug for helping us. Can we go ahead and hug her? We're going to go ahead and give our friend Annika a hug for helping us out with finding our drone, and we're gonna invite her back to our house. Annika says, well, look, I'm a mom, I can go ahead and help you take care of the twins until she gets back. So they're gonna go ahead and head back to the house to take care of the twins. Okay, so these ladies have gone ahead and headed back onto Lakeisha's house. They're gonna go inside and check on the babies. As they walk into the bedroom, they realize that the babies are fine, they're all good. And Annika goes ahead and asks some more questions, you know, who's the dad? And Michaela says she has no idea. It was just a one-night stand at a bar, but apparently he already has a life. He's married with kids. And Lakeisha won't tell me who he is or anything because she just doesn't want him involved. She doesn't want to ruin his life. So Annika stays back and maybe she goes ahead and looks at the babies and, oh no, they've started crying. Annika, are you going to do anything about that, sis? So Lakeisha came home from work and she's going to go ahead and introduce herself to Annika. Annika feels a bit awkward, so she's going to head back out and talk with Michaela. But Lakeisha's going to go ahead and take care of her babies and then go ahead and age them up. And you know what? Annika and Michaela can be around for that. That's fine. So in this situation, we're going to go ahead and imagine that Lakeisha sort of recognizes Annika, thinks, hey, she's familiar, but maybe I just know her from like Hollywood. Maybe she was a co-star or a background actor once. You know, she knows a lot of people, she sees a lot of faces. Maybe she just looks like someone she used to know, but she doesn't draw the correlation that she was the woman she saw in her baby daddy's house the other day when she was peeking through the window. We're gonna go ahead and egg these kids on up, and then we're gonna go ahead and, you know, see what Annika thinks of the babies. Maybe if they look a lot like the dad, she will recognize them. Okay, Chloe aged up. I think Chloe is going to be a very silly little girl. Isn't she the cutest? With her auntie Michaela. And now let's go ahead and age up Noah. Ooh, Noah has bright red hair. Just like his dad's. And they definitely look a lot like Lakeisha if we just go ahead and have a look at their faces. Yeah, they look a lot like Lakeisha, but they also look like Princeton. Especially our little boy over here, Noah. He definitely looks exactly like his dad. Oh my goodness. Okay, so I think Annika is going to come on in here. Let's go ahead and maybe call her over. Oh, she's taking out her trash. Isn't she such a nice lady? And we're about to ruin her life. So we're going to go ahead and call on over Annika to come and have a look at the toddlers. And, you know, just meet them. And maybe we can go ahead and get Noah over here to try and interact with her. And maybe that's when she realizes, hey, this kid looks a lot like Princeton. And maybe she's thinking that he looks a lot like what my kids used to look like. And I think maybe Lakeisha is remembering something she didn't quite remember before. And she's thinking, holy guacamole, is this Princeton's wife? And maybe she went ahead and asked her to go ahead and head on back to Michaela's house because she needs to put the twins to bed now. I wonder if Annika is going to go ahead and draw the correlation between these kids and Princeton and the fact that maybe she was cluing onto the fact that her husband might have been cheating on her. Who knows? But the toddlers are really cute. I'm going to go ahead and give them a makeover. Oh my goodness. I'm guessing Lakeisha is standing right here. Yes, she is. We're literally Lakeisha right now. Because she's making some cute faces at us. But we're going to go ahead and give them a makeover. And Annika might go ahead and head on home and maybe chew Princeton out a little bit and say, hey, remember that night where you didn't come home? You said you're at your friend's and I had suspicions about you cheating, but you said you definitely weren't. What went down that night? Princeton was upstairs asleep in bed when Annika returned home from visiting Michaela and meeting the toddlers. She came upstairs, stormed into the bedroom, and woke up Princeton, confronting him about how much the toddlers looked like they could have been his babies. And she asked him to be honest with her and tell her exactly what he was doing that night when he didn't return home until the next morning. Annika began to get real mad as Princeton kept on assuring her that he would never cheat on her and that nothing went down that night. He went to the bar with some friends, crashed at one of their houses, and came home the next day because he wasn't safe to drive. Annika knew this was false. She confronted him about the toddlers, and he said that he had absolutely no clue what he was talking about. Of course he didn't. Lakeisha had never told him. But he didn't know that he actually had two children of his own out there in the world with Lakeisha, the girl he had had a one-night stand with. He couldn't believe it because he simply didn't know the truth, but Annika felt like she did. They were lucky that the yelling wasn't waking up their two beautiful sleeping children. They had no idea that they had two more siblings that they never knew about and that they were probably going to never get to know. Princeton went ahead and argued back with Annika. She thought he had him exactly where she wanted him, but little did she know that he honestly had no clue what was going on. She tried to explain and reason with him, but that's when Princeton started to get physical. Annika tried to make things better, but Princeton rejected her. She tried to go ahead and calm him down, but that only made things worse. He didn't want to wait to talk about it. He wanted her to believe him now. After all this, Princeton went ahead and admitted it. He said, "You got me. You're right. I did cheat on you that night." And Annika was furious. She went ahead and told him that this was over. If he had cheated and he possibly had kids, their relationship was over and he had to leave right away before the children woke up. Princeton went ahead and went outside to leave, and Annika cried herself to sleep. She didn't know how she was going to explain this to her kids in the morning, but all she knew is that she didn't want that man in their lives anymore. Princeton had no clue where he was going to go. He had this house, this beautiful wife and family, and he never expected it all to come crashing down on him because of a one-night stand. And he was starting to think that, hey, maybe I do have two children that I've never met before. He decided to go ahead and crash with a buddy who was a builder in Del Sol Valley. Princeton's friend couldn't do much for him. He already had a wife and kids of his own staying at their house, and his wife did not want some deadbeat living with them. So his friend went ahead and said that he could stay in a crummy trailer that he had on a building site that he was still working on. He could stay there for 3 months, but soon they would need to go ahead and begin progress on the build. It was bad, like real bad, but it was better than living on the streets or having to stay with his wife who had just said that she wanted to file for a divorce. He looked around and it didn't take long before he had seen everything. It was tiny and bad and smelly, but he went ahead and cried himself to sleep in his cold, dark trailer. So yeah, as you guys just saw, Princeton has gone ahead and moved into the trailer over there. He is living in there because his mate is a builder. He went to go ahead and live with his friend, his only friend that he knows, who lives in Del Sol Valley. He said, "No way, Jose, I've got a wife and kids. I don't want you here. My wife doesn't feel comfortable with you being here considering you got divorced because you're a cheater and like she just doesn't want you around the kids. You can go ahead and stay in this trailer I have though. It's on this plot of land. Here are the keys. Don't let anyone in. I'll be there like next week to commence building, so make sure that you're out by then because I need to go ahead and build a house on that plot of land." So last night, Lakeisha didn't hear anything. She is very tired and so are the kids. They didn't sleep very well last night because there was noise outside, which was of course Princeton. So he is over here. I've actually just locked him in here. He's got everything he needs, so I'm just gonna let him take care of himself. I'm literally not gonna do anything to him. He actually lost his job. I guess maybe his like boss found out that he cheated on his wife. Maybe they worked at the same place, so they aren't like they don't want them there because he cheated, and now the wife's like upset, didn't want to come into work and said it was because the husband cheated, so he got fired, whatever. Michaela is just living her best life, you know, doing whatever she wants. And I think Michaela is going to go ahead and call up Annika. She sent her like a drastic text message last night saying that she kicked Princeton out, that he is a cheater. And Michaela is like, "Whoa, are you okay? Whoa, slow down. Like, talk to me. Tell me everything that happened." And Annika says, "One night, like about 2 years ago, he came home late from a bar. He went out with his friends and he didn't come home that night. He didn't come home till like the next day. And I had suspicions that he was cheating. He smelt like another girl and he didn't come home, but he denied it at the time and I trusted him. But when I met the toddlers yesterday, they looked an awful lot like Princeton. So I went ahead and confronted him again and he admitted that he did cheat and that they very well may be his kids because the girl that he was mentioning was a lot similar to the girl he remembered sleeping with. So he got kicked out." Now Michaela is thinking, "Oh my goodness, is Lakeisha, like did Lakeisha have a baby with my best friend's husband? what is going on. I feel like Michaela will be really conflicted. Maybe she doesn't believe it. Maybe the kids aren't Princetons and Annika is just overreacting. But he said that he cheated and he said that the girl looked a lot like Lakeisha, so she just doesn't know what to believe. And I think she's going to go ahead and confront Lakeisha about it, because I feel like if this is true, I feel like she's going to have to pick between being friends with Annika and being friends with Lakeisha, sort of, you know. She can't be friends with both because there's such an awkward middle ground that she's being placed in. I feel like she'd want to choose one or the other. So Michaela is starting off really nice, just questioning about the kids' dads. Lakeisha said she doesn't want to talk about it. And Michaela goes, I know who the dad is. He was married, he has kids, and he is my best friend's husband. Like, it's Annika's husband that you cheated with. And Lakeisha's like, whoa, 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 like, what's going on? And she starts to come full circle and realize, holy guacamole, it definitely is. I recognize her. That's where I remember her from. And she's still eating her dumplings, though. She's not really that phased. And Michaela is like, I'm out of here. I can't look at you. I can't believe you slept with my best friend's husband. And Lakeisha's probably feeling a little bit bad, a little bit confused. But I guess now she has some more answers as to why Annika was being so weird around the kids yesterday. And maybe she's going to go ahead and confront Princeton now that he knows exactly who he is and what is going on in his situation. But Michaela is going to go ahead and call up Annika and confirm, yeah, she's pretty sure it was Princeton. He definitely cheated with her. They're definitely his kids. Like, what's going on? Are you okay? And Annika's like, yeah, I'm feeling better. I told the kids that their dad's like a deadbeat. He needs to leave. Like, she told the kids something that made them really on her side. So they're fine. They're upset that he's gone, but they understand and they're being really supportive. And Michaela's just so frustrated because she doesn't know what to do now. Like, who should she support? And I think she's definitely going to be more on the side of supporting Annika because she feels like Annika is more of the victim in this situation. And Annika's just going through a lot. So Michaela's going to go ahead and either like disconnect herself completely from Lakeisha, or maybe even move out. She might go spend some time at Annika's house to support her, but right now she just feels like she can't even look Lakeisha in the eyes. Okay, so Michaela went ahead and got someone to install a fence separating their backyards, and she's got some trees planted in the backyard, some shrubbery, some bushes and flowers, which all looks kind of dead right now because it's like wintertime. But she got these installed so she can have some privacy and be completely separated from Lakeisha and her children because she just doesn't want anything to do with them. Okay guys, we've rocked up at the acting gig. We are over here and we need to go ahead and do all this good and fun stuff to go ahead and get ready for our day. So let's head on over here and get into hair and makeup. She is here for this gig. It is Wild Flames, which I'm pretty sure is a TV show. So all we need to do is go ahead and earn gold today and we'll tick off this. We might be able to get up our acting skill. And then on Sunday, so tomorrow, we're going to go ahead and go to the Star Accolades and go ahead and hopefully receive an award. We'll have to go ahead and see. We might not get that till like next week. And in this part, I just want to get her up to 3 stars. I'm sick of her being 2 stars. It just doesn't make sense that she would be like in TV shows and whatnot and not be a 3-star celebrity. So we're going to go ahead and do whatever it takes. Oh my God, they took her eyelashes off. They snatched her eyelashes. Okay. But we're going to go ahead and just work on her acting skill, and she'll definitely be getting into like the 3rd star tier because it just makes sense that at this stage in the LP she would be. At this stage I don't have an ending point for this thing. Oh my goodness, they made her hair blonde. We're definitely going to have to dye her hair blonde. I might also do that soon. But yeah, it is New Year's Eve today, which is why these guys are in here like drinking alcohol. So we might have to go ahead and do something about that in the next part. Maybe we'll have like a party and then go to the Star Accolades or something. But at this point in time, I am just going to be going ahead and working on her skills to get her up to 3 stars. I don't know when we're going to go ahead and end this LP. We're at part 18 and the season's LP was part 30. So I'm not really sure. I think what I'll go ahead and do is probably aim for it to have at least 30 parts. But the thing is, if it is the kind of situation where we get to part 30 and there's not even an announcement for the next pack, then we'll keep on doing it. We'll probably just do this until we like finish it up to what extent we think we've finished it, or until a new EP is released. Okay, we have our set today, which is very beautiful. We've got like a little bakery or something back there, a little shop, and then we've got these beautiful trees, this beautiful forest background, and then we've got like a little table. Oh, there's a duck in there. I love ducks. a campfire, a tent, and another tent. So let's head on over here and go over here and do a risky flirt. Now, I could not do this. Like, it just wouldn't let me do it. I tried it so many different ways, trust me. So we're gonna try and do it riskily, even though this could go badly. If so, I like apologize, but trust me when I say I tried really hard. I tried it with multiple different Sims. I tried it like in public, in her home, on her home lot, like all different ways, and it wouldn't work. They just kept on saying that they didn't have room, even when they like definitely did. So if you have any advice, go ahead and let me know. But they're just gonna go ahead and practice their flirt scene. I think it's going well. Like, I think that's it. Oh no, they're still flirting. Okay, I think this is going fine. Yay, they did it. Okay, even though she didn't practice, it still went okay. Okay, now we need to go ahead and do a risky kiss. Okay, it could all go downhill from here. Let's see if they can do this okay. Oh, she looks kind of nervous. Okay, let's do this. Okay, is she gonna go ahead and kiss him? Okay. No, she got rejected because she hadn't practiced it. Oh my goodness. Okay, I'm so sorry. Oh, that was awkward. Okay, we really need to get a gold on this. So I hope that the rest are about comedy. Okay, yeah, risky tell story. And hopefully that one's comedy as well. And once we finish the performance, hopefully it gets us up to gold, because we really need it for that aspect of our aspiration. Oh my goodness, I don't even have a joke that she could be telling right now. Maybe something about how, hey, you know how funny it is when you find out that your baby daddy's wife is your best friend's friend? Okay. She wouldn't even like bring her private life into this, I don't think. Okay, let's go ahead and do a risky tell joke. Didn't we just do that? Or was that a tell a funny story? Okay, we're over here telling our joke. I love her composure face. Okay, let's do this, girlfriend. Oh, she looked right at us. That was so cute. I just got like starstruck by her. Lakeisha is such a beautiful sim. Okay, she's telling her funny joke about something to do with a relationship. Okay, there we go. We got gold. Okay, the set has closed down and we're going to go ahead and finish this on up. Let's see. Come on, go ahead and finish. I just want her to... Okay, she got $1,517 and two fame thingies. Oh, she got promoted. Let's go ahead and go home so we can check out what she progressed. Okay, she got promoted to Rising Star. New auditions have become available. Lakeisha is now a B-lister. Her celebrity presence is really taking shape. She can now confidently call herself a B-lister. As a three-star celebrity, she can now give hugs to or take selfies with her fan. Unfortunately, paparazzi have also started to take interest in her day-to-day life. Watch out for them when she's out in the public. Thankfully, there's a way to retain some semblance of privacy when hitting the town. Lakeisha can use a mirror to apply a celebrity disguise, which will allow her to walk freely amongst the general public. You guys, we're a B-lister, and we also got this. So in the next part, we're going to go ahead and celebrate New Year's Eve. Go ahead and receive an award on Sunday, hopefully. I'll work on her acting skill. Let me just go ahead and switch on over to the popularity aspiration. Okay, so she completed that milestone because she became a 3-star. She now needs to become a 4-star, be asked for a selfie 3 times, and deal with the paparazzi 3 times, which we'll definitely do in the next part as well. So she is now a level 7 actor. I think we'll go ahead and do one more gig with this agency, then we'll go ahead and move on up to Grand. So let's go ahead and see, what have we not done? We've done Wild Flames. Let's go ahead and do Detective Law. Tough authoritarian figure needed to play distributor of justice, Detective Law. Detective Law patrols the mean streets of San Myshino's northern west corner of the Southeast District. Wow. Distributing fair justice, catching crazy kooks, and finding innovative uses for handcuffs with hot romances. Ew! Okay, she needs to get her fitness to level 5. She starts tomorrow night. Oh, wait, we'll be at the show, the award show. I'm gonna go ahead and do it because I'm not sure if she'll win like a prize anyway. We could go and stay there for as long as we can because I think it starts at 6, so maybe we'll just go for the first hour and then leave, and then we'll have to go back next week and we'll just work harder on doing more auditions, so hopefully she can get an award the next time. I think that's what we'll have to do. So what we're gonna go ahead and do is, look, she's a B-list. Okay, we have two fame points. Do giving back, gain reputation even faster by donating objects to fan for fame. Celebrity serum, help receive helpful potions in the mail, or all-nighter, boost energy, host marathons, and charity streams. I think we'll go ahead and do the giving back because she does have a good reputation. And maybe the Celebrity Serum, because I haven't seen that one before. Yeah, we need to get our fitness skill up like 2 points. So we're going to have to go ahead and focus on that in the next part. In the next part, we'll be going ahead and working on her career, her aspiration, and her skills. And maybe we'll have to go ahead and find out that our baby daddy is living in the trailer next door. Until next time, I hope you have a very snazzy day, and I'll see you all soon. Bye, guys!